Well, thanks for talking to us. We've got Michael in Tennessee coming up next. Michael, are you there?
Hello?
Hello, yes. Michael.
Hello?
Can you hear us?
How are you today?
Doing fine. What you got?
I'm a Planet President, Prison Planet member calling from FEMA Region 4. I've got y'all's free bumper stickers and passing them out like water.
Thank you, sir.
I used your Procure, all et cetera. Anyway, I called Alex about a month ago. I'm the Constitution Bill of Rights news sticker idea guy. I think y'all should run the Bill of Rights as a news sticker at the bottom of your screen. But I wanted to point out something about the Constitution. Everybody's trying to mess with it. And I'm going to tell you, the Bill of Rights itself says in the first four articles, the first letter of all of the first four articles spells out the words can't. I think it can't be any plainer than that. I'd also like to point out that the milestones to our road to freedom should include wonderful things like Badandi's awesome non-mainstream questioning and all of also Alex's Pierce Morgan takeover show. I'm going to say I think it's unusual that the Twin Towers, and they originally were calling this the Twin Bombings. And I'd just like to know if you think there were any videos that showed dogs, bomb-sniffing dogs that were actually alerted and then kind of asked to turn down. And there are people all the time, I'm saying a lot of stuff here, but I want to get it out and then you can comment. But people say all the time, what can I do? Well, I, in about the last 2 months, have become extremely proactive, and I've called on my phone 93 calls to senators and state representatives against unlawful gun controls and for teachers to be trained, which, by the way, in Tennessee passed. And are there any websites that show any information about Dr. Pechenik's reporting on the Obama-Bush-Clinton indictments? And now I'll leave it to you, and that's all I wanted to ask.
It was pulled down, as addressing the Pechenik question that was pulled down, but I do believe it is on Planet InfoWars. And you can probably just type in the search.
And I don't remember the name of the website, but they did have a one-hour video there, a press conference, and you can look at the full 600-page report. That organization, and I don't have that right with me right now. Maybe we can get that later. But I tell you what, Michael, I really appreciate your activism and your support of us, but your activism with Congress. And one thing to put on your list, you've been very active calling people, call about CISPA. Mm-hmm. That is something, there's a lot more Republican support for it than there is Democrat support. So we still have a chance at defeating it in the Senate.
Right.
And we've got to remember that SOPA and PIPA and even CISPA itself in its previous incarnation that wasn't as bad as it is right now, those were all defeated, even though all of the people on the House committee were co-sponsors of it. It was pretty much a done deal when Aaron Schwartz started fighting it. And they brought that thing back. They delayed it, and they brought it, you know, kept publicizing it and resisting it until they stopped it. So it can be stopped, but we have to get active, just like you've been active. And in terms of the number of videos and things that are going to show any bomb-sniffing dogs at the finish line, I think we're going to see a lot of stuff continue to surface over the next months and years. You got to remember that we just talked to Mike McNulty, who did the Waco Rules of Engagement and then Waco, A New Revelation documentary. And it took a long time for the information about exactly what happened at Waco. Mm-hmm. People knew that the official story was contrived, false, contradictory, but it took a very long time to find the exact information, and it took him a while to discover it. And he actually was successful with Freedom of Information Act to uncover some information that the government had never had out there before. So I think eventually the truth is going to come out. We know, though, from the get-go that there's a lot of suspicious stuff here.
And keep in mind, a lot of people had their cameras and such confiscated by the authorities when it happened. They even admitted that on CNN. We have to take these cameras because there may be information on them. So that will make it somewhat more difficult, but I am confident there are people who have, even if it's just in the background, they have the bomb-sniffing dogs or whatever else going on.
Absolutely.